So there has been a lot of speculation as to what will happen after all of the content for Classic WoW gets released. Will we get brand new content added to Classic WoW, or will we get new TBC servers? Well, we finally have the answer to this question. Not too long ago, a few people have received emails from Blizzard with some very interesting information, asking them how they would want to see classic Burning Crusade servers get released, which pretty much confirms that Blizzard have been working and developing on classic TBC servers this whole time. So this all started when some guys on Reddit were reporting that they had been getting emails from Blizzard, asking them how they would want to deal with a character transfer for Burning Crusade servers. Now, to prove that this wasn't fake, multiple people have shown the exact same email and survey that they had received, so this is legit. The survey was only given out to a few select people, and not everybody got to do this. The survey asks if they would be interested in playing Burning Crusade era servers, to gauge their level of interest. However, the second question asks how character transfers should be handled. Now, the main contention is what will happen to the characters on classic servers after all of the classic content is released. Should the characters that already exist on classic servers get transferred to the new Burning Crusade servers? This question is a huge admission from Blizzard. The fact that they are asking how we should deal with character transfers for Classic WoW to Burning Crusade all but confirms that we will be getting Burning Crusade servers. In a way, this is like getting a spoiler for the real announcement. My bet is that they are saving the official announcement for next BlizzCon, and when the classic phases are reaching their conclusion, this will be their big moment to maximize hype for this project. This survey asking if people would want to play on classic TBC servers is a formality, since I believe that they began working on TBC servers shortly after Classic WoW was released. So getting TBC servers at this point is almost a certainty, about a 99% chance it will come of a few months after Phase 6 in Classic WoW is released. Now, unless there is a major community backlash from the WoW player base telling Blizzard that they don't want to play on TBC servers, I can't see how Burning Crusade servers won't come out. The only people that I have heard raise questions about TBC servers are those who are worried that it will come out before Phase 6 in Classic, and it could divide the Classic WoW community before the final patch is out. I find this scenario highly unlikely. I mean, I don't think Blizzard is as stupid as to release TBC servers before Phase 6. I just don't think that's going to happen. Now, the main piece of information that Blizzard wanted to get was to know if people would want to see their characters get transferred from Classic Realms to TBC Realms. Now, there are a number of selectable answers to this survey question. Answer number one is basically having all of the classic servers automatically progress to the Burning Crusade expansion, with an option to opt out of the Burning Crusade and make your character go to a stasis classic server where it's stuck in Phase 6 forever. Answer number two is the same as number one, except for progression to the Burning Crusade is not automatic. You have to opt in your character to transfer to the new Burning Crusade server off the classic server. Answer number three is to start a brand new character starting at level 58 on a TBC server. Answer number four is to have a brand new character starting at level 1 on a TBC server. And answer number five is none of the above. So the main contention is, should we transfer our characters from classic servers to TBC servers, or should we be forced to start fresh new characters? Now, both options have their own merits, and I will go through the pros and cons of both. So as we all know, the way it worked back in the day was that everybody went into the Burning Crusade with their level 60 characters. There was no new servers or character transfers to stasis servers or anything like that. It was pretty simple. All the characters that you played with get automatically taken to TBC servers no matter what. However, Classic WoW is functionally different from vanilla. The Classic WoW project is about preserving the past version of the game. So whatever happens, we definitely need a version of Classic WoW to remain as is, at least in some form. Now, these servers where it's stuck in Phase 6 forever are probably not going to be as popular after TBC comes out, but it's important that we still have it. We don't want a situation where there's going to be petitions for Blizzard to bring back vanilla WoW servers for the third time. So keeping Classic WoW as a playable option is very important. But the issue that people have with transferring already existing level 60 characters to TBC is mainly to do with gold. The idea is that if a lot of people can bring all of their gold and items to the Burning Crusade, they will be able to have a big in-game advantage and be able to pre-farm Burning Crusade before the expansion even comes out. Think of it this way, it costs about 5,000 gold to train an epic flying mount in the Burning Crusade. However, there are a lot of classic players that already have 5,000 gold on them already, including myself. So if we could transfer to the Burning Crusade today, the gold farming part of the game would be trivialized. Epic mounts, enchant materials, and consumables could all be pre-farmed before Burning Crusade even comes out. Now, of course, theoretically, this could have been done back in the day of 2007 as well, when the Burning Crusade was brand new. However, the gamers of 2020 are a whole different breed to what they were in 2007. You know, people would be no-life and gold farming for months before the Burning Crusade comes out, knowing that they could complete some of the content before its release. This would essentially create a big gap between the most hardcore players and those who are casual. Pre-farming the Burning Crusade definitely happened back in the day as well, however it wasn't that big a deal. Now in 2007, the average WoW player was still clicking on the spells and playing on a square resolution monitor. This era of Twitch and YouTube where guides exist for min-maxing every aspect of the game simply did not exist. In 2020, you can bet that if character transfers are allowed, every WoW YouTuber will make a 5 things you need to do before the Burning Crusade or how to farm gold before the Burning Crusade type of videos. And a lot of people would go into the Burning Crusade already rich. So that's the main bone of contention that people have for character transfers. Although transfers from Classic to Burning Crusade servers could cause some balance problems in the economy, it's simply the way it was done back in the day, and it should be replicated today. We all have put a lot of effort into our characters, from the 1-60 grind, to gearing out a pre-raid best in slot list, to going to Molten Core, and all of the reputation grinding and so on. I think it's reasonable to have some level of sentimental attachment to your main. My Nomage is my own project, and I wouldn't want to abandon it to re-roll a Draenei or something. I think a lot of people have the same feeling. There's going to be a high amount of people that will want to continue their character's progression into the Dark Portal. The alternative is to roll a level 1 brand new character and literally go through the Barrens to Eastern Plaguelands again. Now my job is to make WoW content, so getting another character to 60 is not an issue for me. However, for the casual average player, I really can't see them wanting to level to 60 again, when they have already invested a lot of their time into working on the character that they're playing already. I think that's a big ask for a lot of people. I think abandoning that character to start a new character from square one is kind of a big ask. Now the other option is to start from level 58. Now I really don't understand this option number 3. Now obviously it's so that you can begin the TBC content from square 1 without having to go through Classic WoW leveling zones, and you can just go straight into the Burning Crusade content. 58 is the minimum level to get into the Dark Portal and to start leveling in Hellfire Peninsula. Now I don't know about you guys, but this sounds like a recipe for disaster, at least for launch day. Remember how laggy and ridiculously strained the servers were for the launch of Classic WoW? Well, if you think that was bad, this option to give everybody a level 58 that will immediately go to the Hellfire Peninsula will be an absolute disaster. At least during the Classic WoW launch, everybody on the server was divided in different starting zones like Durotar, Elwynn Forest, Dunmoreau, and so on. With option number 3, where everybody gets a level 58, everybody on your server is going to be funneled into one zone. Now imagine Hellfire Peninsula with literally all the server's 10,000 people there. It would be literally unplayable for days. Way worse than Classic WoW's launch ever was. At least with forcing people to start at level 1, the amount of people that are going to go through the Dark Portal is going to be trickled in. Having everyone be given 58s and just immediately go to Hellfire Peninsula is just going to be absolute chaos. Definitely needing to bring back the layering system if that's the case, which as you guys can remember caused quite a bit of drama back in the day. Now that being said, Hellfire Peninsula and TBC zones are going to be flooded regardless. I mean, if we have character transfers, Hellfire Peninsula is going to be a war zone pretty much no matter what. However, if everyone and their mom gets gifted a brand new level 58, it will simply just amplify the problem with overcrowding. To be honest, I have no idea how Blizzard is going to deal with a classic TBC server launch. the strain on their servers is going to be absolutely crazy. That being said, having everyone start at level 58 is going to ensure that nobody can bring their wealth from classic servers to TBC servers. So it's kind of going to be like evening out the economic playing field. Which, depending on who you are, is a good thing or a bad thing. To be honest, there's no right answer to this. In my opinion, I think it should be answer number one, where everybody just gets transferred to TBC servers, and if they want to opt out, they can. At least that is my preference, but I'm really curious to hear what you guys think. How should character transfers be handled going from Classic WoW to Burning Crusade? Let me know down in the comments below. If you guys enjoyed this video, please drop a like down below, as it helps me out a lot. This is Vaulty, signing out.